guess who's back? Back again. Shady's back. Tell a friend. Guess who's back?
That was the problem.
But you know what? I'm intrigued to want to know how it would have. I want to know how it would have turned out had we would have got Spider-Man in like '92 when it was originally pitched. Because a part of me wanted to see the web slinging superstar J. Mary Jane on the Brooklyn Bridge. Now that I know that that was planned, I kind of want to see it. Maybe I can find a parody for him, Spider-Man. Just saying.
Yeah. First of all, And second, it is out there. Because there's a scene where... Because there's a scene... Once again, when you download movies and you don't put the right extensions behind it, you sometimes get things you don't want. But no, speaking of parody, there is a scene where... You know the scene in the Spider-Man movie where Mary Jane kisses Spider-Man when he's hanging upside down?
Yep. Yeah.
He's kissing something else.
I hear what you did.
And then if I'm not mistaken, there was a full-on Spider-Gwen parody that happened too. I remember being a kid coming across that.
Speaking of Spider-Gwen.
I feel like you still got it.
Speaking of Spider-Gwen, first and foremost, RIP to Spider-Gwen. They officially killed off her series. But they are bringing back the Gwenpool series, though.
Ooh.
She's actually going to be a part of somebody's team. So there will be the return of Gwenpool. Now, personally, I feel like a lot of this stuff is happening because Marvel is allowing the cinema division to dictate the comic book division.
I feel like it should be the other way around.
I feel like Marvel should not have to write a script because comic books keep giving you the new script.
Just put it on screen. Like,
right. So like at the end of Logan, I refer to it as Old Man Logan. Okay. At the end of Old Man Logan, we clearly got the birth of X-23. She's there. Yep. She's here. She's now officially part of Marvel. Okay? Why don't y'all just go ahead and make that movie? The story is there. Create her backstory, like her real backstory. Okay? You can do coming to terms with it. You can introduce Wolverine in that. If you want to do a new Wolverine, you can do it off the back of X-23 if you want to. You can bring Gabby in. You can bring in Honey Badger, okay? Which I feel like the all-new, all-different Wolverine was a great story. And I'm glad she's getting her own solo book starting next month. But you can introduce Honey Badger. If you want to go ahead and make it different, you can have it. You speed up the age of X-23 that she's not a kid no more. You can say she's been training with Alpha Flight because you dropped the Easter egg of Alpha Flight in Deadpool. Okay? You showed her crossing the border to get to a team on the other side in Canada that can help you out. So you have your Alpha Flight reference. Bring her back. 20 years later, she wants to shut down the facility that created her. You get to the facility, you see they still cloning her. They still trying to make more of her. Or you can even use the sisters, a Laura storyline, where you had the four clones of Laura and they came to find her because they're slowly dying because unfortunately they never got the healing factor like she did. And you come to find out that there's still one more, which is Gabby. So the sisters plus three break into the facility. The four sisters die through the process. You get Gabby. And now your X-23 series is created. You got Gabby. You got X-23. We come to find out that Gabby and Deadpool are best friends. It writes itself in so many words. Like, you can literally do that. Therefore, now you can have your new Wolverine if you don't want to replace Hugh Jackman. You can still do it. Because she rocks the X-Force outfit sometimes. Matter of fact, she rocks all the Wolverine outfits sometimes.
It's
there.
It's there.
It's all there. They need to pull a manga. Well, manga and anime is probably the closest, in my opinion, of just taking from paper to show.
Fact.
Even the fight
big
scenes,
fact.
They dang near get it to a T.
Big fact.
If they could just take that same mentality, movies would come out faster.
True.
Or at least make a bunch of damn TV shows. I don't know. Maybe I'm asking for too much.
But you're not. That's the good thing about the age of streaming that we're in right now. Getting TV shows on Netflix, Hulu, we can do that with ease. You can easily go ahead and turn an X-23 comic book into a TV series. You can easily go ahead and make a Colossus Kitty Pryde story movie. Matter of fact, you can even do a slick that you can just do it 2 seasons, 26 episodes, 2 seasons, or even if you want to break it down even more, you can easily go ahead 4 seasons, 8 episodes each season. One whole story arc is done right there. And that's another thing. Comics give you story arcs, bro. You don't even have to work anymore.
You don't have to do nothing.
Like, you don't. Like, we did the new Teen Titans story arc last time. Could you imagine if they just took that whole series? That's a TV show right there. That's the Teen Titans show. If you were going to reboot it. Okay.
And they could.
What universe does Spawn belong to?
Technically, he should be in 616.
What the hell is that? Is it DC or is it Marvel?
It's Marvel, bro. You can't say what universe.
I'll say what universe.
You can't say what
universe. 616.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure that
you can't
say. You gonna give me an area code?
Ooh, 619. That's not an area code. You're not a heavy comic book reader, so I'll give you a pass. When you say universe, when you say universe in comic book world, we automatically think Marvel, okay? Because Marvel breaks their multiverses up into universes, and then they label their Earths with a number behind it. The main continuity storyline that majority of all stories come from in Marvel is Earth 616, okay? The Ultimate 1218, something like that. There's a bunch of different universes. So when you say what universe somebody's come from, most people would say, hey, this is this universe, and they'll give you a number. Now, if you say DC, hey, what universe is Power Girl from, they don't go by universes. They go by Earths. Earth 1, Earth 2, Earth Prime, Earth something, which that brings up a good point. Power Girl is from Earth 2, right, Baron?
One more time, you cut out.
Power Girl is from Earth 2, right?
Man, I'm taking your word on it.
Okay. And this is my thing. Power Girl is from Earth 2, but Supergirl in the Arrowverse is from Earth 2.
Yep.
So are you secretly telling me that that's Power Girl? Because she only her name from Supergirl. She only changed her name from Supergirl to Power Girl because her Earth got destroyed, and she ended up in Earth 3, where the main continuity comes from. So she changed her name. Apparently, she got titties, too.
No. Hey, so, okay, speaking on that, so is this why when they run into the Nazi version of, I don't know if you caught up, they run into the Nazi version of Supergirl, is that why they call
Crisis
it something else?
X.
Like they don't.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Crisis on Earth X. they don't even they made it seem like she wasn't even really a part of Earth. Like, she didn't come to Earth at all. She was from somewhere. Well, we know she's from Krypton, but what am I trying to say? They basically tie into what you're saying about her being Power Girl.
Right. Well, the one on Earth X is not Power Girl. That is supposed to be, instead of Superman crashing on Earth, she crashed first.
Got it.
That's what they did. So Superman never made it here. She did. And I take that back. The movie, the TV show uses Supergirl because, well, technically, let's be honest, that freaking Superman that they have sucks.
Trash.
So, but they also made her the main character anyway. But no, it technically is supposed to be Superman because he's the Red Sun, S-O-N, and whatnot. So it should.
Oh, with the whole Russia when he landed in Russia.
Yeah, that's what Earth X is supposed to be, or Earth 10, as it's really referred to. They just use X because, well, they special. But yeah, a lot of them are, a lot of DC Earths are numerical, but they're like in a more sequential order than how Marvel's multiverse is all over the place.
And you are 100% right. The origin of Power Girl was retold as Supergirl for Earth 2.
Yep, that's what I thought. So technically, if they were to destroy Supergirl's planet and bring her over to Arrowverse, she technically should become. She should
Power
become
Girl.
Power Girl. Also, just to fill in for you Arrowverse people, the same the Earth that Gypsy is from, that's Earth 8. Bruce Wayne being a Kryptonian is actually Earth 5.
Oh shit.
The Crime Syndicate. So for those of you guys who've seen that that one random Crisis on Infinite Earth animated they did, that's actually Earth 3. So Earth 1 is supposed to be the Silver Age storytelling of DC. So the Barry Allen, Hal Jordan, Ray Palmer. So basically the continuity that Arrowverse is using is actually Earth 1. Now, Smallville is from too, ironically.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. I'm trying to find. The new gods are on Earth 14. Animal Man, Bawana Beast. They're all from Earth 20.
Is it?
You got to remember there's more. Okay. So there's multiverses, and this is how it works. Everything has a decision, okay? Thing has an action and a reaction. If you choose one path compared to choosing the other, it's supposed to split off and create other Earths or other multiverses. So what the theories are saying is certain characters made different decisions than what we've come to know, you get a completely different outcome, and this created a brand new timeline. So for an example, if the night that Batman's parents got shot, if Bruce got shot instead of Thomas, that's a whole new Earth. So there's an Earth where Batman is Thomas Wayne, not Bruce Wayne.
And he's killing people. Okay? Doesn't he kill people?
He kills people. He has a gun.
Yeah,
an Earth
he said that with so much joy, like, oh, my God, he's killing people.
Hey,
then
man.
There's one where Lex Luthor never existed in the continuity at all. Okay? And believe it or not, that does make a big difference. There's an Earth where what we call villains are actually the heroes and vice versa. Okay? There's one where the Themyscirians didn't stay in hiding. They actually came out and they took over Earth.
So it's just a bunch of alternate realities.
Yeah. what it boils down to is a bunch of alternate realities or different things that flip. Comic books started doing this so they can create storylines without messing up the main story. So, like, if they want to kill Peter Parker in the Marvel but not stop the Peter Parker world, we'll kill Peter Parker, we'll go over here and do this instead, and poof, you got Miles Morales. Or what if...
Or Spider-Gwen.
What if Gwen Stacy... Yeah, or Gwen Stacy gets bit by the spider instead of Peter got bit by the spider. Now she has to run out here and do this. You know? So a lot of different things happen because of this.
So how y'all feel about the Spawn reboot I think is coming? I watched this story on Complex, and apparently they've got Jamie Foxx to play Spawn.
The only way I would be 100% okay with this is if I forgot the guy's name, Black Dynamite, if he wasn't still acting.
Michael John White.
There you go. He looks exactly the same. He's just as active. He's just as ready. As he was when the movie came out, what, in the 90s?
But you know what?
The problem.
I think they got Jamie. I think, this is just my theory. I think that they went with Jamie Foxx over, you know, recasting Michael John White. Because Jamie Foxx is a bigger actor than Michael John White. And I think that's just how they sit.
And I can see that.
Funny.
Sometimes when you look based upon, like, a lot of people go see movies based upon who's in the movie. Like,
true.
That, like,
very
me,
true.
Me and Tom had this discussion because he asked me about, like, when the original X-Men came out, I don't think it was about the actual comic book or the cartoon that we grew up on. They sold the movie based off the actors that they got to play in the movie, which is why people went to see it, because we got a Hugh Jackman, who turned out to be a great Wolverine, but Hugh Jackman had a name. And
true. We got,
like,
Patrick Stewart.
Right, like, they sold this movie based off the names. It wasn't fresh-faced actors that we had never saw, and now we're selling you on the fact that this is your childhood now come to life because of the X-Men. They sold us with the actor that they got to play these roles. I don't think it's like that now. I think they sell us more of the comic book aspect, and now we can't see any other people playing these roles. Like, I really couldn't. I can't imagine Tom Cruise being Iron Man now that I've seen Robert Downey Jr. do it for the past 10 years.
I can't see
Tom Cruise doing that.
I mean, but that's why I go with the original theory I said earlier, cast all brand new. Like, let's take a look at, like, let's use the X-Men for an example. Big cast, the original cast of X-Men based on people you already knew. Like, we knew Patrick Stewart. We knew what's-his-name who played Magneto, because they have had bigger roles in other movies. We knew Hugh Jackman for what he was working on during the time. We was okay with that. Everybody knew Halle Berry, so that wasn't a big deal. You ended up getting what's-his-name to play Beast? Frasier. Can't think of Frasier's real name. You got Frasier to play Beast. Kelsey Grammer, yes. But you got big names. But then when it was time to fix the timeline, time to reboot the timeline, you eliminated all the original known people. Like, the people who you got now, you may know a couple of them, just a couple of them, but majority of the cast you've never seen before. Or you've seen them in very small roles. Like, yeah, I know who Zoe Kravitz is, but before that movie, can you name anything else that she had been in at that time?
Nope.
And, you just knew that, hey, that's Lindsay Kravitz's daughter.
And that's why I feel like when they do certain reboots, like, if you're going to reboot, I think I said this with the Blade character, like, if you're going to reboot Blade or if you're going to reboot Spawn, we need a fresh face and a younger guy. That way, depending on how long you plan for this character to be around in this universe, we can grow with them like we grew with Robert Downey Jr. over the last 10 years. Now he's synonymous with Iron Man. Or Chris Evans getting his second chance, as we will call it, within the MCU because Human Torch sucked. I'm sorry.
It wasn't his fault.
Just like Daredevil wasn't Matt, what's his name? Dylan? It's not Matt Damon.
Ben Affleck. No, it's Ben
Affleck.
Like, Daredevil ain't all his fault. I mean, the movie was, it was a bad movie. It was poorly written.
It was commercial.
But that's also is going to be a long-term issue because every comic book movie from here on out, minus the Inhumans, are literally set to always have at least a 2 to 3 sequel. Like, there's going to be at least 3 more Deadpool movies because old girl who plays Veronica, when they were all on Good Morning America getting interviewed, she was like, yeah, you know, I signed on to a 4 movie deal, so, you know, me being dead, I'm not surprised. I mean, I'm dead, but I'm not gone. And,
hey,
of course,
out.
If you've seen the ending, you know she's not dead.
Check this out. I believe we touched on this before. Wouldn't it be a cheap way to bring in Mistress Death is have her become Mistress Death?
I would roll with that.
Instead of having to introduce a whole new background and a whole new character.
I feel like if they don't do it with Thanos, then that will be a great way to put her in them, to put her in movies, because she's more infatuated with Deadpool than Thanos in the comic book. So I can see them doing it that way. That probably would be dope.
That could definitely be a good bridge. I can live with that, but I don't think you should make it the whole platform of it, you know. But okay, so here's a good question. Now, we all know that eventually this MCU that we've come to love has to migrate to something different, okay? Do you feel like the all new, all different characters that they have created, that they're kind of writing out slowly, should be introduced into the MCU? Now, for those who don't know, a lot of your favorite characters got rewritten or restructured. Like Hawkeye, his daughter took up the mantle, which I can live with that because he has a family. We already know he has a family in the MCU. The Hawkeye we know is old, so sit his ass down. So that's one person. We already know about X-23, a.k.a. Laura, Wolverine's daughter.
Mm-hmm.
We already know about Miles Morales.
Because I know that there's a female Iron Man, right?
Yeah, it's a black chick. I forgot her name.
See, and I think Riri and Amadeus Cho were the two characters that ticked off people with the new, all new, all different characters. Because Jane Foster becomes Thor, which they finally let her die. I actually liked Jane Foster Thor. I liked the story behind it. But because off a few key people to make that possible in the MCU. Well, you know what? Let me let that go because they about to bring everybody everywhere. They're going to recant the whole MCU in a minute anyway. So it ain't going to matter.
You know what? Because I was thinking that, like, because I have these weird random comic book conversations with my coworkers because they're young white kids and they love this shit. And I was thinking, I'm like, well, because eventually, if they don't die out, they're going to slowly fade away into the background, or everything's going to be a buddy movie because there's no more solo movies. But I feel like if they do another Iron Man, why not this next Iron Man be like, okay, Tony finally hangs the suit up. Like, if you've seen the Infinity War, Pepper Potts even made reference to, you know, we need clothes and shirts in your closet, not these suits, and, you know, you chase a monster around. So maybe if you do Iron Man 4, it's him, you know, finally getting rid of the arc reactor, him living a normal life, and he just passes the mantle on to someone else. And I think in the comic books, it's a woman.
It should be Riri.
Why not? I would like it to be Riri. Of the next Iron Man movie. That way, you know, Phase 4, Phase 5, whatever we're going into could be more about... Well, not Phase 4, because I think they're going cosmic. But whatever the next regular phase is when they're on Earth, just slowly everybody's passing on. I mean, Bucky becomes Captain America. Just, you know, do stuff like that. That way it's not a complete reboot, but you can slide in a different direction with new characters so it doesn't look like a reboot.
I feel you. And I think that actually would work. It would work brilliantly, only because, like we said earlier, the movies are starting to dictate what the comic books do now. So a lot of key characters that are being written out right now while they're rebooting Marvel completely would definitely come back. If they do go ahead and, let's say, let's bring Riri in. I think a lot of people did not necessarily not like Riri character. They didn't like how they introduced Riri. They made Riri be some chick who's super smart, who goes to a plain ordinary public high school, and she builds her own version of an Iron Man suit in her house. She goes out and tests it one day. It doesn't have any weapons or anything in it. She's just out here kidding around with it, and it gets picked up on Tony's scanner. Tony, you know, comes up and runs up on her, questions her what's going on, likes her brilliancy, and then turns around and gives her a job. But in the same comics, they also say that Riri is smarter than most of the smartest minds in the MC in Marvel, including Tony. So it's kind of one of those, she's smarter than you, but you don't want her to be above you, kind of a thing.
What if Shuri was the new Iron Man?
What if who?
Black Panther.
His wife? Oh.
Shuri could, you know what, I would roll with that. And this is the reason why I would roll with that. Shuri already proved that she's technologically advanced and far superior than anybody in the MCU right now, period. Okay? She's 16-year-old. So you can still go ahead and use that young girl being the new Iron Man kind of a thing. At the end of Black Panther, they already opened up that Wakanda's research facility in L.A. anyway. So all it takes is, during the Infinity Wars, Tony seeing what she can do, Tony wants to come and wants to have her work on stuff, and next thing you know it, Tony wants her to come help her work on a suit. She pops the wall open, boom, it's already a suit that she had already been working on. She already has her own Iron Woman suit.
And that would fit with the new Marvel outlook on the superheroes.
Marvel's going to cut me a check if that happens. They'll cut me a big check, and we'll never have to work again,
I mean, all I want is 10% of whatever you get, bruh, because I did the show tonight that gives us audio evidence that you said it, and it's time, dated, and stamped. So 10%.
Facts.
Whatever. That's all I ask. Man, no, but that would work. Okay. So we got Iron Man covered. We got Captain America covered. If Shuri doesn't become the new Black Panther because T'Challa keeps getting his ass whooped,
losing every fight.
They better off letting the leader of the Storm Elijah be the Black Panther, bro. Her hands valid.
You go ahead. We take Scarlet Witch. We take Scarlet Witch. We make her crack because of the fact that she had to kill Vision. Boom. The reality got reset. We got mutants in the world now. So instead of making no more mutants, she creates mutants. Mutants are now known and present. So now when we wake up, there's mutants everywhere. Therefore, you can introduce mutants you need into the MCU. What else? Storm is sick of this shit. So she leaves the X-Men, joins Black Panther. Now we got Black Panther and crew. Oh, snap. Yes, we can actually do Black Panther and crew for Black Panther 3. For those of you who don't know what Black Panther and crew is, there is one story arc where Black Panther comes to America. Him, Storm, Luke Cage, the black chick from the Sisters of the Sword, Moon Knight.
Oh, no,
is it Moon? No, that, not Moon Knight. I can't think of her name.
I was about to say, Moon Knight's a woman? Look, you almost threw off everything for me.
No, I can't think of her name. Thinking of Moon Knight while I look this up.
Let me stop. That's too black. Like, Black Panther was black enough. That's too black. That ain't going to happen.
It's not too black,
Black Panther and the crew, fam. They're too black. too black.
He said, is it too black because it says and the crew?
And the
get a Netflix series.
They, you know they'd have to call it the Guild.
You know,
Misty Knight. That's what it is. Her name is Misty Knight. Because you know she just got the arm. Yeah. All of them. It's, okay, it's a whole crew.
I might be interested in that. But then wouldn't that be kind of crossing the movie and the show universes together? And ain't they trying to say
that? But I see no reason why not to. Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. has basically been a behind-the-scenes telling of this whole Marvel cinema for the whole past 10 years anyway. Like, they've using Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. to springboard a lot of characters, including the Inhumans, the whole Loki situation of how the Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. even started to begin with.
Did they ever explain how Dude died and then came back alive?
They probably did, and I just didn't pay attention because I didn't care.
But that was one of the mysteries. Of like, so you died in the movie, and then the first episode of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., you chilling. Yeah, they explain that one.
Oh, that's right. So it was Black Panther.
I thought he faked his death to inspire
in Manifold. Nah, he died, bro. The Tesseract killed that
man. Oh, shit.
Yeah, dog. Matter of fact, okay, well, here's the thing, Juan. Just because you said you don't want to cross the two, you can technically do Black Panther and the crew as a Netflix series.
I mean, she's gorgeous, though, you know? How you doing, Miss Lady? You good? I said, hey, Miss Gorgeous. She's out of this orbit. And she's not flawless, but she is the beast, my puzzle's missing. My mission is to find her, blind sign her, refine her, remind her that she's my first draft. I gotta sign her.
I got you, love.
To long-term deals. She is the car, I am the wheels. Let's take off. You ready?
Ride, sweetheart.
I'm ready, love. I said, name is gorgeous. She's out of this orbit. And she's not flawless, but that only makes me wanna be down her. Say pardon, slow dance to Marvin. Thirsty niggas starving, flowers for the garden. Ball of chips hardin', steady head bobbing. Got a hard noggin, mobbing, slobbing. It's got a double meaning, stop triple beaming. Henny got me leaning, seeming like the baddest. Think I gotta have it, smooth shit a habit. I want it, I grab it, tag it. We live in lavish, the mathematics. Craftmatics, asthmatic. When I see a gasping, remind me of the great Gatsby. The one that went the hard, that's me.
She's gorgeous, she's out of this orbit, and she's not flawless, but that only makes me wanna be around her. That much more my name, that much more my name. I said, hey, Miss Gorgeous.
And just not have Black Panther there, and just have the crew under the leadership of Black Panther, like he sent orders from Wakanda.
From what
you can, do it from, you can make it, you can do Siri. Siri, Siri could be the one who comes instead because of her relationship with Storm. There you go. That's how you fix it.
That's
somebody
another,
from the Dorad. Or somebody from the Royal Guards can take his place.
I heard Moonlight might be getting a Netflix series. Would y'all watch that?
And that's what I was getting ready to say. If you want to do a side movie, Moon Knight should have his own solo side run movie. Okay? Because
from what I watched on the comic book Explain and the Vibrant, like, he like Batman on like level 10, like dog out there,
but
like
he's,
really bad.
But he's not. But he's not. That's just it. He's like Batman, but he's not like Batman. He can be compared to Rorschach, but he's not Rorschach. It's how you read it. And the thing about it is there's two different volumes to Moon Knight. The first volume is where everybody compares dude to Batman. The second volume is a crazy dude inside his mind. And the way the writers write it, they write it so good that you don't know if dude really out here doing this or if he's in an insane asylum going off some good drugs.
Oh, shit.
Because the way he broke it down, he was like, dog is nuts. He out here just wild.
He is. And that's why I said you can write a really, really good movie off volume two. Like, it's a comic book movie, but it's not a comic book movie. So it's like, here's this patient. You started like they're in an asylum, and he started narrating, talking about his life as a superhero. What was that movie with Leonardo DiCaprio in it, and he was on an island, and he thought he was investigating the place? It
Shutter
literally
Island.
Would be a Shutter Island.
Ooh,
it would literally
shit.
Be a Shutter Island. It can be done. That's why I'm saying,
so
dude, this whole entire...
So he's like a sociopath, schizophrenic superhero, but it's all in his mind?
And yes.
That'd be interesting. I'll watch that. Like, because it sounds like it's happening, but it's not happening.
Right. And if you get the right directing team behind it to go ahead and write the story, visually, it can be... Think about it. Doc Strange is somebody who I would not have ever picked up a comic book and read, but the visuals for the movie and everything about the movie made me be like, you know what? This is dope. And I can
you
see
know what?
A Moon
I would,
Knight movie being like that.
I would need the people from Legion to make it. Based on, because I don't know much about Moon Knight other than what you guys are saying. I've heard about him. I always thought he was compared to Batman. But here in this detail, I would need the people from Legion because they would be able to do the jump cuts. They'd be able to do the weird, is this real, is this fake? Like, for those who, man, please tell me, Legion does that beautifully.
It does. I'm trying to find which volume I need you to read. I'm trying to find the volume.
Like,
talk amongst yourself
like,
while I look.
Yeah,
like,
okay.
Like, don't feel bad because I don't like how Tone reads the comics. I'm more of I'll sit on YouTube and just like the backstory and because they
got
explain
you.
The comics, so I don't have to read them.
Got you.
But they make them interesting to where it's like, okay, if I was to ever jump into stuff like this, these are the people I will read. And he was explaining Moon Knight, and I was like, so he's like Batman, but he's just like he feels like a sociopath, like he's more out there than Batman. He's like a vigilante times like 1,000.
And what's so dope about that and hearing the fact that he's crazy and he's potentially, it's potentially not even happening. The show Legion, the way it's laid out, the way they, the way it's shot, I could totally see this. Because, and then all you would have to do is, okay, I'm kind of jumping pages, but the way the Arrow is. The action from the Arrow, but with the cinematography from Legion, boom, and you got Moon Knight.
Okay, it's Moon
yeah,
Knight Volume 6. So read Volume
Moon
6
Knight,
and you'll get.
Yeah. You know,
yeah,
I got
like
my
every
notepad.
Time we do a show, bro. Like every time we do a show, you got homework.
Yes,
yeah,
sir.
Put that on Netflix. I'm watching. Now
I'm watching.
I'm a little, And I feel like they turn in, like, maybe it's just me because I don't, like, read comic books, but I feel like they're turning a lot of shows that I've never, like, heard. Like, I ain't going to say I haven't heard of them, but, like, you barely saw them when you saw the cartoons and the shows. Like, I never heard of The Runaways before they put them on Hulu. I still got to watch that. Tom told me it was pretty good.
It's pretty
good. And Cloak and Dagger. I had never heard of Cloak and Dagger until I was watching, like, Spider-Man.
And you know
is
what?
That
and
they this is why they did pop up in Spider-Man.
And you know what?
The Amazing Spider-Man that was on Netflix before they took it off, they had a few appearances on the Spider-Man show.
Yeah, because it was part of a particular story arc.
And this goes back to what you said, Juan. Like, it's never – I don't think this will ever end because of how deep this goes. Look at Ant-Man. I personally think some of the best Marvel Universe movies to come out were some of the random ones that caught me off guard. Ant-Man. I think
Ant-Man was dope.
Bro, that was one of the best fight scenes I've ever seen, and it was in a child's bedroom.
Oh,
that sounds creepy.
Look, my bad.
But the next one is going to be dope, though. But, like, did you see some of the preview trailers for the next one?
Yes.
They're going into the Microsoft world, and they're going to fight there. There's rumors that the original Wasp, they're going to find her down there. They're going to say she got stuck in that universe. So the new Wasp mom, Hank Pym's wife, is stuck down there, which after I thought about, dude, I'm kind of glad they went with Scott Lang and not Hank Pym to do the Ant-Man series, because everything you've just done in Marvel would have to get rewritten. Because a lot of stuff Tony got blamed for, Hank actually did. And then we got to sit here and actually realize that, like, Hank Pym slapped his wife. And he's schizophrenic. And he has multiple personality disorder.
Hey, just like, thinking of that is the, like, he used to be, like, when they had the Avengers cartoons on Netflix, the Ant-Man was, like, real life always slapping that Wasp. It's like, why is this on TV? Like, why is he getting so aggressive
for
her?
But like,
the random movies that the MCU put out,
he only hit her one time in the comics, and they keep bringing it up. He did it once.
Well,
ooh, Clone Wars.
She ain't had that hot place.
Ooh, Justice No Justice, number 4 is that? I got to read that.
Like what you were saying, like, I do feel like the random movies or the movies that you know the least about do kind of be the dopest. Like, when I first heard of Ant-Man, I was like, okay, I'm going to see it because it's Marvel. But then I really was like, okay, what they're going to do with it, because I knew Paul Rudd's history. Like, Paul Rudd is funny. I'm like, most Marvel movies ain't comedies. Like, there's comedy in them.
Yeah.
But it is not, like, Paul Rudd was a 40-year-old virgin, knocked up, like, he's fun.
Yep.
And to see what he did with the character, it was like, okay, I can get behind the Ant-Man franchise. I'm with it. I'm here for whatever they do, because that's dope.
And you know what? They missed a serious opportunity. I forgot the character's name, his Hispanic homeboy. If he would have narrated everything, they could have seriously just had him narrate everything from the beginning, from Iron Man, all the way up to Infinity War. And that would have been dope.
The Hispanic dude is funny, period. Like, period. Because anything Dog has ever been in makes me laugh. Because he was in, what's that movie where a little dude got the bomb strapped on his chest? I can't think of it, but it was one movie where he was supposed to be the drug dealing dude, and he was out there trying to be the one to collect the ransom, and they was messing around.
It wasn't a delivery. I know what you're talking. Yeah, they said. I know exactly what you're talking about. Oh my god, I don't know about the show.
Does the next day air?
Ooh, small. Nah, because
that was a dope movie too.
Because dude from This Is the End is in it, too. He's the dude making them sell making them get the goods and put the bomb on him.
Let me see.
Hold on, I'm gonna find it. Talk amongst yourself.
Got you.
Danny McBride.
Hey, no, but
Danny McBride is.
Is it 30 minutes or less?
I think it is 30 minutes or less.
It is 30 minutes or less.
It
yep,
is.
Yep, that's it.
Oh, yeah. Because that part when they go to the what was the Family Dollar and they buy, like, spray paint, plastic guns,
Yeah,
hey, okay, I got to
ask. Plastic guns and a couple of shooters in our face.
Hey, so.
Biggest boss and I've been in Trillis. I'm a bigger problem when I click with Skrillex. Murder on my mind, it's time to pray to God. My revolver's not religious, the revolution's born. You wanna know my name, then go and tell us all. You wanna know my gang, Suicide Squad. Pistol on my waist, I might make a mistake. Dead shot, oh my God, am I crazy? Drugs every corner, this is Gotham City. Killer croc, came to kidnap you to cut out your kidney. Ain't no mercy, got that purple Lamborghini lurking. Rosé, so she know that pussy worth it. Flooded Rolex at the Grammy Awards. They still selling dope, that's those Miami boys. Killers everywhere, it ain't no place to run. Forgive me for my wrongs, I have just begun. Ain't no mercy, ain't no mercy. Huh. Got that purple Lamborghini lurking. Ain't no mercy, ain't no mercy. Huh. Got that purple Lamborghini lurking. Rosé! Don't be begging for your life, cause that's a lost cause. High stakes, body armor, suicide, boy. It's the time for games and it's the time to kill. Make up your mind, baby, cause the time is here. Capital murder, capital letters. Yeah, she catching my vibe, but she can't fathom my chatter. Need a couple gang members for these new endeavors. From this point on, anything we do together. Body on the corner, million in the trunk. Seven figures I spend at every other month. Killers on the corner, talents in the clip. Build a palace out in Paris just to fill with bitches. Say my name and I'm coming with the gun squad. Everybody running, homie, is only one gun. Cocaine, white Ferrari, I'm in the fast lane. Every day was life and death, that's when the cash came. Count money, drug residue, even blood on it. He had a driver until I put my cuz on it. Kicking in the door for the Suicide Squad. Needle in my arm, so I'm do or die for it. Ain't no mercy, ain't no mercy. Huh. Got that purple Lamborghini lurking. Ain't no mercy, ain't no mercy. Huh. Got that purple Lamborghini lurking. Rosé. For my wrongs, I have just begun.
So what's a random comic book run that you want to see hit either TV or movies?
A random one. You know what I was just
one that's not
one.
Most popular.
That's not most popular?
Yeah,
of course,
not,
my
you know, not one of the gimme.
My first one, of course, is going to be Power Girl because that's my chick. But honestly, though, I would have to go to, like, one of the other comic companies that we don't really listen to.
Dark
like, we
Horse,
all know Marvel.
Or not.
We all, you know, yeah, but, like, Dark Horse, Boom, Atlas. Hell, I even, you know, Top Cow and Image. A lot of people forget about Image. because they do make a lot of comic books that become movies and whatnot. But and they also do a lot of video game based movies. If I'm not mistaken, I think Image actually does the WWE right now too. But there is a particular series under Image called Cyber Force, which I actually feel would really be a really good one that they can run with. Another one is called The Circle. It's literally just a comic book about nothing but espionage.
Ooh.
What else? Now, if I want to stick in Marvel and DC, for those people who know actual stuff, see, it's kind of hard right now because Marvel has really been on a run in releasing every single name into a movie in a one shape or form. Like,
yeah,
really nobody who doesn't have a movie or doesn't have a show. That I think about it. Just
okay.
X-Men's been okay, going cool. on for years. Spider-Man's been going for years.
I'm gonna go old school now. Like, I would like to see. Maybe they don't have to do a movie, but I would like to see a live action adaptation of the Biker Mice from Mars.
I'm not mad at you, bro. I don't know how you'll pull that up, but I'm not mad at you.
You said what?
I said, I'm not mad at you. I don't know how they'll pull it off, but I'm not mad at you.
I don't know how. They did. I mean, I think everybody would look like Chuck E. Cheese in the movie, but
right. If you do that, if that's the case, then can we get a live action of Samurai Pizza Cat and the SWAT team?
Hey, man,
Samurai Pizza Cat.
Hey, if they get down, bro, I'm with it. Like I
no,
am,
but real okay.
Maybe it's just
okay,
me,
I got one.
I am really clamoring for a live action Family Guy movie.
Ooh.
Okay, I can see that.
I want one so bad, like just a Family Guy movie, live action. We get somebody to play Stewie. I always wanted the live action Boondocks movie.
We should have got that. Or at least they need to reboot it. They need to reboot it and grow them up to at least in high school. High school I can live with. High school Boondocks.
Well,
all right, go ahead.
With the Boondocks, didn't they kind of run him into the ground? Is like they wanted him to produce episodes on a massive level?
No, they wanted to go a different direction, and Aaron Magruder didn't agree with what they were trying to do. So they was like, well, we really don't need you. We got enough following. We'll get new people, and that's where they went. All right, I got one for you. I got it.
Season 3 of the Boondocks was trash.
Yeah, I don't. I wrote it out of continuity.
Not canon.
It didn't happen.
Not canon. This is a what if series. All right, so here's one for you. Now, Baron, you might agree with this because by opening this door, this Pandora box, it gives us so many things you can do. I feel like how they did Gotham, and they did all this backstory based around the villains. They need to do it with Madripoor.
Oh shit!
Okay, what's that? Break it down for me. Break it down.
Okay, so in the world of comics,
you got excited, so it's got to be good.
There's in the world of comics. There's this city where the criminals can go. And everything is off limits. This is like your cesspool of Marvel. Every bad guy, every villain, every hero who's trying to hide, every I don't want to be who I am anymore, they go to Madripoor. The city of all cities. This is where you go hire your assassins from. This is where you go get your dirty intel. Madripoor could be utilized in such a great way as its own show. Like, the fact that Baron hasn't said nothing since then, his brain just broke. Because
So is this like Suicide Squad on another level?
It's not even Suicide Squad. It's like, damn, I'm trying to think of a place. Okay. Think of it, the bar that Deadpool goes to get his assignments, and every bad guy in the city is in there. but this is a whole city the size of Chicago.
You know what, man? But who would you pick to tell the story from? Or would you just tell it like Gotham?
You would tell it like Gotham. You would tell it like,
okay,
here's the kicker. Here's the kicker. Question. The thing about it is every season of Madripoor has a different hero or anti-hero having to come there. And you kick off your first season with Wolverine.
Ooh.
You don't even have to put him in the Wolverine outfit. We can do it like how we're in Gotham, but there technically is no Batman. You can literally have a Logan walking around. He's never Wolverine. You can even make it more of a detective show. Places like The Question can be here. Psylocke could be here. Domino can be here. Rogue can be here. Gambit can be here. A lot of characters have to come through Madripoor, so you can make it work.
I would watch that. That sounds dope. It sounds interesting, too. It sounds like it'd be violent.
It would be dope as hell.
What if they
And we already know Marvel always steals from them. Marvel always goes after DC. So it would actually fit perfect.
Because let me break it down. Here are known people who have lived in Madripoor. This is how you can run with it. Angel has lived there. Beast has lived there. Cyclops, during his bad Cyclops run, has lived there. Karma has lived there from the New Mutants. Magneto has lived there. Boom. Season one can kick off with Magneto if you want to. Marvel Girl, Scorpion, Jessica Drew. So, boom, even better. If you don't even want to kick it off with Magneto, kick it off with Jessica Drew. Because she's a private investigator in the most corrupt city known to mankind.
Dude, that would be... And you know what? I wonder, because I haven't finished Legion yet. Did the Shadow King go there? Or is he from
Shadow
there?
King went there. I think he's from there. Shadow King has been there. You could put Cloak and Dagger in there if you need to. Captain America could come there looking for somebody. Spider-Man comes there looking for people. Wolverine comes there looking for people. Blade has hunted vampires in Madripoor. Heroes for Hire
this would retcon Marvel TV
shows. Yes. Like, a lot of people have been there, dog. A lot of people have been there.
Holy shit.
Literally, Madripoor. Am I even saying it right? Madripoor.
Madripoor. Yeah, that's how I would say it.
Madripoor. Madripoor, okay. Like,
that sounds like a who's who of just infinite. Like, so do we get like all new people to play the cameos, or like do you get Chris Evans from Captain America to make the cameo?
That's the cool part. But that's the cool part. You can do either or. You can do either or, because it's just a cameo. Unless you're going to base a storyline around one specific character. Like, if Wolverine is hunting Dr. Doom, and the last known place you knew he was in Madripoor, you can cast all new Wolverine here. Like, I didn't cast Wolverine like 3 times in this episode. I'm just saying, you can put a whole new Wolverine, because it's open. I'm just giving doors to bring Wolverine. Deadpool. Boom. Your Deadpool series can be right there. There you go. Take him, the blind black lady he kidnapped, Weasel Barr can be there.
And bam, got a whole damn series.
Whole first season, DP in Madripoor. From there, you introduce X-23, her and Gabby hunting somebody. Gabby, boom, now the story moves from Deadpool to Gabby and Laura. during the hunt, during there, boom, you slide, in Captain America.
And you know what? When I'm seeing this, I'm seeing a Deadpool that you never see outside of his suit.
So suit all the time?
Because of course, suit all the time. Because I can't
export.
Picture.
Gotta be export.
There
Deadpool.
You go. Yep.
Matter of fact,
because
matter of fact,
Ryan
his whole
Reynolds
squad,
is, I don't
whole
think
squad.
He'll do the TV show.
So you can get away, but he might write off on it though.
Mm.
Or even better, put the X-Force in there. They're the ones always there. That way you can help. You can have Terry Crews redeem himself as his character.
Yep. That was
so
awesome.
Whole
X-Force. Bro, the way they hyped that up and then the way they killed them all was perfect. I had never been. Shit was perfect.
I knew something was wrong because they never interviewed Terry Crews.
Ooh.
No,
okay. Quick fix. Because he wasn't going to be there. Quick fix. Quick recant to my previous story. We can't use Wolverine, of course, right? Because even if he does it, the movie cinema uses it. But you know who you could use? He looks like Wolverine. He's a little gay. You know, he wears a brown and yellow suit. He's related to Wolverine.
Sabretooth? Wolverine? That would be dope.
Nope. You can do Sabretooth living there, but you can have Draken.
Oh, shit.
Because Madripoor at one point in time is actually ran by Draken.
Oh. I
love how deep this shit goes, man.
Yep. That's the TV show we'll create for Marvel. It will get all my money.
So
Marvel, I want to check.
Do y'all read the Power Rangers comics? I didn't know.
No, but they have a new... No, but there's a new game. There's a new Power Ranger game out where it's Power Rangers versus X-Men, and it's on your mobile device. And it's free.
Oh, shit.
I'm going to download that right now. No, because I was watching something and they was explaining how apparently there's an alternate universe and Tommy is like Lord Draken or something, and his soul is to kill all the
Power Rangers. I was just reading that. You must have been watching Comic Historian, because that's where I just seen that, and I just started reading. I seen that. See, I put you up on something, bro, and you getting your shine on. Okay, so from the DC world.
I saw they did a trailer for it, and I thought it was kind of like cool. Then I saw Jason David Frank, so I'm like, okay, it's not serious. It's a teaser to something. So what's the teaser for? And then it was for, I guess they've been working on this comic of this alternate universe. I guess he takes the mantle of Lord Zedd, and he's not a new king. He's set to kill all the Power Rangers.
Okay, so in the DC world, I actually have two shows that I would do coming out of DC. They would come, one would be on Fox, and one would have to be on the CW in order for this to work. All right, so the first one is one I feel should have been done a long time ago, and it's the Green Lantern Corp. Like, don't focus on Hal Jordan or anybody like that, but focus on the whole corp itself. I think it is, but how many movies turn to TV shows afterwards? It can be done.
I can see that because apparently the next Green Lantern movie is supposed to be like a buddy cop thing, which is they're supposed to introduce the black guy. What's his name? John Stewart? Or is it Hal Jordan?
Yeah,
Hal Jordan's the white guy, right?
Right. Well, one of the white guys.
Yeah.
Like four of them. Like three white guys and a black guy.
Because Tyrese has been campaigning.
Take a wing, yes!
We're not giving Tyrese money.
You know what? Tyrese, he would be too funny.
John Stewart is too serious.
That's what I'm saying. He'd be way too goofy.
I think Idris Elba will be John Stewart just for the fact that we may not see Heimdall again in the MCU.
Only
people are jumping ship back and forth getting this money.
I wouldn't give it to him. I wouldn't give it to him only because he's Heimdall, dude.
Bro, we don't have that many incredible black actors.
Hey, look how many retcons we've seen. We saw Johnny Storm become Captain America.
We've seen Catwoman become Storm. We've seen Johnny Storm Killmonger. Like, Johnny Storm is just a cursed role.
Yeah.
I mean, what incredible black actor.
Art's a platform to boost you to somebody better.
I got one for you. No. I got somebody for you. No. That's why I wouldn't pick him. He's a perfect guy. He plays biographies anyway. So let's go ahead and give him an action. Let's put Derek Luke. Derek Luke can be John Stewart.
He would be an older one. John Stewart.
I feel like I ain't seen Derek Luke or Antoine Fisher. Have I missed him?
You've missed him, but he would be perfect.
He would be.
He'll be perfect.
No, I'm just saying.
That's a good vote.
I would still say Idris Elba. I feel like he borderline made for that. But
he has.
I can't argue with Derek Luke.
Derek Luke would be a good choice.
Well, you know, Connie was casting like the original Green Lantern movie that they were going to do before they got Ryan.
That doesn't work, bro. It doesn't work for me.
What do you mean? You got beef with Connie?
It's Connie. Did you forget that Derek Luke was one of Captain America's Howling Commandos? He was the only black guy on his squad.
You know what? Speaking of that, now, do you think it would be worth it if we got, like, a TV show, not even a TV show, but, like, a Netflix series that kind of chronicle where, like, the backstory of, like, how they created Captain America and then how it went drastically wrong and how we ended up with Weapon X?
You talking about, so basically how? So you want, so in so many
ways, the Manhattan Project, but for Marvel?
Right. Basically, you want the Weapon X storyline, but start from after Captain America didn't work. What do we do next? Because technically, in the lore of the Weapon X, Captain America is the first weaponized choice, and Logan is the 10th. That's why it's called X. There are actually eight other people in the middle, one of them being Mystique, Sabretooth, what the hell was Will I Am character's name in Wolverine's origin?
Oh my god!
Why was he there? Oh, there's a reason why.
Because he was
because of the Weapon X
because
program.
He was part of the Weapon program. Yeah. But Weapon
why,
X.
What was his damn name?
Captain America is pretty much like how it started, though. Like, they created the super soldier thing, and it worked on him, and then they just kept going. Because isn't that what...
They kept trying to recreate it.
Isn't that what kind of created the Hulk, right? It just went wrong. The super soldier sound, right?
All right, let me run it down for you. Now, the first weapon, which was Project Rebirth, was actually... Isaac Bradley. So they create the Super Soldier Serum with Steve Rogers, and then they try to recreate it, and then that's when you end up getting what is known as the Black Captain America, which was Isaac Bradley. So he was the first one. The second one was...
What they call him? Is he a hero? What they call him?
Who, the Black Captain America?
Yeah.
They call him the Black Captain America. No, that was his name, the Black Captain America.
Oh, that's so racist.
Dude, you got to remember, comics came out in a time when Negroes were,
sure,
black people
were
still. So,
it was okay to be racist when comic books were popular. I get it.
Weapon X 2, 3, and 4 were all on animals, which secretly, they don't say it, but I feel like this is where Rocket Raccoon came from.
A squirrel with the animadium body.
terrible.
speaking of Rocket Raccoon, I wouldn't mind an adaptation of Star Fox, but that's maybe another.
All right. Then there was another one. They did again during the Vietnam War, and this is when they created Nuke. Nuke and Black Budget. That's a terrible name. It's terrible. Weapon 8 and 9 were actually tested on paths, one of them actually being pulled was number 9. Mystique is actually one of the weapons as well, too, which in Wolverine and the X-Men cartoon, they actually touched on that. Trying to think. There's somebody missing. Dude, there was a weapon project person known as the Skinless Man. That is terrible.
Shit sounds like Fallout.
How we got like the Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and, you know, do you think it would be worth creating a show around the Weapon X program? Or, you know,
hell yeah.
You definitely could. You definitely could.
Cause all right, so the like first one. Creating the story, it would just give so much backstory to, you know, all these characters that, you know, we may not really know about. Just create more.
All right, so my other one. Oh, my other Marvel one. Now we're here because we're getting ready to get close to the end of the show. My other Marvel one, which will be more so for the kiddies, but the adults will get it too, would be The Adventures of Squirrel Girl. I don't know what it is about Squirrel Girl that everybody loves, but I feel like she needs her own show to explain it. And then my last DC one, a newer one, and I feel like we can get away with this in this day and age, which would be, no, bro, this already been happened. The Super Sons. Being the fact that we have now found out that Superman, they keep making movies say that Superman has a kid, because the Superman Return movie, Lois, that was a whole issue about that whole movie. So Lois was pregnant, and now we got Damian Wayne running around causing all kind of problems all over DC. They put them together in a comic together where one is lighthearted but doesn't know nothing about superheroing, and the other one just doesn't know how to be a kid. Put them two together, make it a TV show. It'd be awesome.
You can get your
Batman and Superman team-up show without having your Batman and Superman. Anybody can play Bruce Wayne. Anybody can play Clark Kent. You've never violated the whole storyline of those two, and you can still keep doing what you do. Hell, if you want to, you can make it Talia and Lois is always the ones there with the kids.
That would be dope.
Damn. I'm trying. Somebody need to cut me a check.
Man, the part that bothers me, it writes itself. It's already written.
Facts. Somebody need to cut me the check, because apparently I just gave y'all next three series to work on.
Because
y'all already doing the Titans. So.
We need to get paid. We need to be consultants. Like, just give niggas ideas. Like, you do whatever you want with ideas, but just pay me for my time and my thought process.
But you know what the bean counters, bro? That's always what gets in the way, money. That's why Ryan Reynolds had to fight so hard to get Deadpool to what it really was, because they didn't think it would work. Hell, he had to leak his own damn test shot.
Hey, but you know what would be crazy about stuff like that is, like, when people pitch an idea and then the studio look at them like, I don't think it'll work. So it's like, y'all don't think it will work, but, like, what he pitched is, like, stuff just like we doing now. We just sit around and think about, because these are things we want to see. So, like, I think what certain people should do is they need to start When is those? They need to start using focus groups more, because just because you know the three of y'all sit in an office building and try to tell us what we would want to see, that's not always what we want to see. Which is why I think early superhero movies didn't do so well, because that wasn't what we wanted.
Not at all,
to.
Bro. If you go and look at early superheroes, period, it was terrible.
Like, I think if we would have had a focus group when the first X-Men dropped, Fox would be in pretty good shape right now. Because we would have said, hey, that is not happening. If you do it like this, then we could go somewhere with that. But that's trash. And you keep making it is really trash.
And then introduce some major characters.
On top of trash.
And then introduce some major characters and not even that we all know are related and not having them be related. Like,
yeah,
Juggernaut, the professor. Look, how many movies did it take before they clearly made it? They clearly said Sabretooth and Wolverine. Like, it just, it's crazy.
Hey, y'all know Ryan Reynolds played Juggernaut, right?
He did.
What?
I wouldn't put it past him.
Yeah, he was under the helmet, and then it was all CGI.
Oh, that's funny.
Either way it goes. All I have to say is I'm glad that you gave us good Juggernaut. Like, cause don't get me wrong, the one that you guys had. I'm not mad at the Juggernaut from the X-Men series, but the Juggernaut here was true to form, and I like the fact that one, you gave the nod to the fact that that's Professor X's brother without saying it, and two, you gave us the classic Juggernaut versus Colossus fights that we always get. Okay? I'm glad for that.
Charles.
like the fact that those two... Because to me, a Juggernaut versus Colossus fight is like a Thing versus Hulk fight. It's going to happen. It's supposed to happen. Mm. And we get upset if it doesn't happen. Or a Thor versus Hulk. Okay, that always happens.
I don't really
best
know
friends,
if I
want to
see
fight.
Hulk fight nobody no more after the way Thanos treated my nigga. Like, Hulk should just retire.
See,
like,
don't put your
fist up to fight nobody.
The fact that you don't let the MCU fool you, because if they would have went with the original War Hulk storyline that they should have gone with, Thanos would never have slapped dude around like the way he did. I'm not saying that Thanos wouldn't have beat him, but it wouldn't have been like two pieces and a biscuit and he gonna bitch up. It would have been different. That's all I'm saying. It would have been different. Or old man Logan Hulk, because that world, you know what, dog? That is another storyline I would like to see. I would like to see a Netflix series of old man Logan.
That would it would have to be Netflix.
Because that storyline itself, that would draw everybody in. See, think about it is, Juan, the Logan movie didn't give you what really Old Man Logan is about, okay? Old Man Logan is about Wolverine, different universe, where all the villains run everything. And Hulk went to the bad side. Him and She-Hulk had incestual lovemaking and had all these little Hulklings, and they all run this wild, wild west kind of an area. Okay? Now, unlike the movie...
Is She-Hulk played by China?
I don't know. But, no. That was only in the porn. But, which was terrible. Unlike the movie, though, because the movie had that Professor X killed all the X-Men because he was old and had a senile break. What happened was Mysterio came in. He warped Logan's mind. He made it think that they were being attacked by a bunch of people. Wolverine is killing everybody left and right because he's trying to protect the mansion while all the X-Men, when Mysterio lets him see, the X-Men were always there. They were the people. He killed everybody, and he vowed never to pop his claws ever again. So, He went off, lived his life, got a wife and kids, the whole nine yards. They living in like Wyoming in like a shack, taking care of business. He's behind on the rent. The Hulks run up on him about getting the rent. Dude said, give me a day. No, give me a week, and I'll pay you back. He goes on an odd job with Hawkeye to get the money to deliver the goods. He thought it was drugs, when in actuality they were delivering a kid to safety. When he got back home, the Hulks killed his family. So he finally pops his claws. He kills all the Hulklings. He goes toe-to-toe with the Hulk, and he finally beats the Hulk. Okay? No, he didn't kill all the Hulklings. He went toe-to-toe with Hulk. Then Battle World started. Okay, this is when all the Marvel universes came together because of Doom. If you want to know what happened there, read Secret Wars. While he's in Battle World, he's wrecking shit to save this kid. Whatever was going on during Secret Wars, they basically defeated Doom. Battle World ended. All of Marvel became one world, one regular, normal world. This is their way of getting rid of the Ultimate Universe, but keeping key people from the Ultimate Universe. Old Man Logan came over, okay? Because in the regular story, they killed Young Man Logan. So Old Man Logan, thinking he went back in time because everybody is younger than what he is, his first thing is to go kill the Hulk of this era to stop any of that from happening, only for him to find out that this world is... So it's not the Bruce Banner Hulk. Okay? This is how he ends up meeting up with Laura, X-23, and Gabby. The Secret Wars go on. A lot of stuff go on. So basically, Old Man Logan could be a TV series, and you can split up three seasons based around this scenario. So you don't have to introduce Battle World in season two, but you can introduce something happened. So now you got new characters in a new area, and then volume three or season three can be now you're in the new world. This is when you start meeting other characters from the Marvel MCU who are no longer being used. So you can make it work. Old Man Logan needs to be a show.
Has to be.
So we've confirmed from Marvel we need Moon Knight, Old Man Logan, and Madripoor. If I see any three of these shows on Netflix or Fox by 2020, I want my money.
Hey.
Want my money. But anyway, people.
To become Iron Man, I want my cash, too.
All right. So, with that being said, people, we want to thank y'all for listening. I will definitely be editing the mess out this show because this was only supposed to be a 90-minute show, and we clearly have gone to damn near 2.5 hours. So I will probably break this up into two episodes. Hey, when you get to talking to people about stuff, it's easy to do. So I probably will break this up into two shows. So because we changed topic completely by like second half anyway, so that's a whole nother show right there. So make sure you guys tune in. Go to YouTube. Check out The Adventures of the Black Nerds. You can also find them on iTunes, SoundCloud, Spreaker, iHeartRadio. Make sure you check out the Def Fresh Show. We will now be recording at 1080p HD quality with the audio that we're running with now. We now record at HD quality. And check out everything else that's going on here at Tone Deaf Radio. So with that being said, let's go ahead and close tonight's show the only way we know.